Greetings, viewers, and welcome to the Lost Islands. The Lost Islands are a land filled with extinct dinosaurs from all different types of time periods living together. In this journey, we'll be exploring all of these dinosaurs, large and small. The island is huge, covering with many different types of biodiversities of different biomes. Forests, woods, deserts, swamps, and even snow. In our journey, we will look at all the dinosaurs. But before we get to our large and mighty dinosaurs like Tyrannosaurus, our journey begins small. This little creature is called Sitakosaurus. It is about 2 meters long and is the size of a large dog. It grew up in the early Cretaceous period and it's the island's smallest creature. And on its tail it is equipped with extra razor long sharp quills, used as like a porcupine. The quills probably would have also been used to attract mates and used for display, but otherwise the only hope this little guy has is living in numbers of the more larger dinosaurs. This male is looking for herd, a large protection of anything. Without protection, it is in huge danger of all types of predators. Luckily, our Sitako has encountered itself a grazing herd of hadrosaurs, accompanied by 2 other species of dinosaurs, a sauropod and a tank. A 6.5 meter ankylosaurus walks with the herd. It is equipped with extremely thick and strong armor covering its back and even its eyelids. On the back of its tail is a very thick and strong club capable of breaking the bones of T-Rex. Being hit by this is like being hit by a rock the size of your head thrown against your body. Ankylosaurus had a very unique sense of smell. Since their head level would have been in the level of bushes, it would have been hard to spot and see predators like Tyrannosaurus. The Ankylosaurus would have been able to smell the predators and would have been able to react. However, despite being this brutal, heavy tank of a dinosaur, it does have weaknesses. Its belly is very fleshy and is unarmored, so predators like T-Rex could easily be able to flip it if caught off guard. This Ankylosaurus is a large female, a mother, protecting her child. She would not let anything close to him, not even the Sitakosaurus. As the sun begins to set, our little Sitakosaurus goes to the nearby waterfall to take a drink. Nearby, the corpses of 2 Myosaurus, a youngster and a mother, lay dead on the ground. The smell of the dead animals attracts many scavengers, such as a single velociraptor. Eventually, the smell of the dead corpses will lure in the more larger predators, such as Tyrannosaurus. It'll be wise for the herd to move. When the sun rises, the herd will move away from the smell of the dead. name Sitacosaurus means parrot lizard, based after its parrot-like appearance. Its skull has a sharp beak, which was used to tear apart and easily cut through plant matter. The skull of the Sitacosaurus is a very groundbreaking and interesting skull of all of dinosaur history. The bumps on the skull, as well as the beak and the general appearance, has led to believe that Sitacosaurus was a very ancient and early and the first form of the dinosaurs' greatest warriors, the Ceratopsians. This is Ava Ceratops, one of the more smaller members of the Ceratopsians on this island. This one was the leader of a herd, a bulking alpha male. However, just like deers and other animals of today, these Ceratopsians use their horns for not just defense, but for battle, for mating seasons, and for territorial rights and the rights to lead the herd. This male has been challenged into a duel, but however he has lost the battle and has ever since has been disbanded from the herd, and now he is alone in search for a new herd to live with. The roars of the predators like Tyrannosaurus echo through the sky, indicating a not-so-distant threat. And with night slowly approaching, the Ava is in danger. But when the night falls, nocturnal predators like raptors come out to hunt. Luckily for the Ava, the Ceratopsian has found itself a rocky shelter to rest in the night. With the predators near, tonight will be a very restless night. When the sun rises and the first sign of dawn appears, the Ava takes no chances and leaves at first light, not risking living near an area of ferocious predators. However, that threat is closer than it thought. Nearby, a Utah raptor prowls the area. Frightened out of its mind, the Ava quickly hides behind some large rocks, hoping to be unnoticed. Utah raptor has disappeared, but now a new threat has arrived. Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Having no chance against the Rex's powerful sense of smell, the Ava was found, forcing it to run towards the raptor, causing its own inevitable demise. Back at the waterfall, the herd has left the area as planned, leaving the velociraptor and the ankylosaurus the only living things in the area. Newcomers like a diabloceratops have also arrived in the area for purposes unknown. The ankylosauruses have nothing to fear because of its mighty armor, but her young hasn't yet adapted its defensive armor, so she should be considering unmoving. The velociraptor, however, chooses to stay since it has all that it needs for now, a carcass to feed and a waterfall to drink from. Despite being a famous box office movie, Jurassic Park is very inaccurate on how they represent their velociraptors. In fact, the velociraptor isn't as large as a human, but is instead the island's smallest predator, being only half the size of an adult human. And because they are the smallest predator, they are rather cautious predators, only hunting small animals like rats, birds, and small arthropods, then take on the risks of hunting something more defensive like Avaceratops. They would also scavenge on bodies of dead dinosaurs if given the chance. Feeling thirsty, the raptor goes to the waterfall to drink. But little does it know, it is being stalked. The tiger of the island, Australoraptor. This 5-meter-long dromaeosaur is a fast predator in the island, easily catching up to the small, quick creatures like Velociraptor. Normally, she would scare away creatures like the small Velociraptor and feast on the carcass of the Myosaurus. But however, this female has distinctively killed the Velociraptor for the purpose of eliminating threats. This is because she is soon to be a mother, and she cannot risk having small predators like Velociraptors roam near her nest. The skull of the Australoraptor tells us a lot of interesting features of what type of dromaeosaur this is. The skull is narrow and elongated, telling us that this has a very weak bite force. And the teeth are not serrated like other raptors in the island, but instead, they are more cone-shaped and are capable of gripping onto small, quick prey. All this information tells us is that Australoraptor wasn't a hunter capable of taking down large prey, but is instead a chaser for small, fast organisms that are hard to catch. Their skinny legs helps them chase down fast prey, and their long tail helps them be in balance and helps them turn around more quickly. Their coned teeth also suggest that Australoraptor was a fish hunter, hence the reason why this female probably stayed near the river. On the other side of the island, another Avaceratops is separated from the herd. And this time, it's a female. Her herd was attacked by Utahs during sunset, and she has injured her back leg badly by falling and tumbling off cliffs. Although she survives the raptors, she's in immense pain, both physically and emotionally. Knowing that meanwhile, someone she knew is probably being eaten alive right now, and the herd assumes she is dead, leaving her behind, alone. Now she must find herself a shelter, or else she will end up like the previous Ava. A new day has come, and this time, there are no predators around. The Eva has successfully healed her wounds and is now able to run freely. And with food and water around, and nothing to fear, this new place she found has become paradise. The unfemale joyfully runs around and swims in the lakes, peacefully playing in her sanctuary. However, this place is missing something. Despite all these good things thrown to her, she is lonely. Without her herd, she has no idea what to do. She knows what she must do. Feeling strong and brave, Ava leaves the area and searches for a new herd to follow. Before she leaves, the Ava gives out one final goodbye to her paradise before her journey begins. And with her luck, her calls are responded. In the distance, a Sedacosaurus answers back to the Ceratopsian. Feeling a sense of hope, she moves forward towards the calls, ready for anything that lies ahead. Thank you. The Ava's journey has led her to the island's wetlands. It is here where dinosaurs go to nest. A mixture of water and a large variety of vegetation with tall plants to hide in, the wetlands seem like the perfect place for hatchlings to be raised until migration. Nesting season has passed, however, so there is no dinosaurs to be expected around here. For now, the Avaceratops will rest and stay here for a while, waiting. Further down by the wetlands, a young Triceratops lies dead on the ground. The youngster must have been left behind by her herd, and without someone to care for her, the youngster has no idea what food to eat and has no protection in this dangerous world. Predators can easily be attracted to this area as a hunting ground. Even though the offspring can be heavily defensive, the prey of young dinosaurs are easy to kill and bring an easy meal. Knowing that this body will attract many scavengers, our Ava moves away from the rotten corpse and decides to rest on the opposite side of the wetlands. Although she knows the dangers of staying here, she decides to stay in case a herd that she can join passes by. Hours pass and the Avaceratops is no longer alone. A single Cetacosaurus has stumbled upon the wetlands in search for protection and water. Although the little dinosaur isn't the same kind as the Ava, our Ceratopsian decides to stay with the Taco for now. The Cetacosaurus will also need the company of the Ava since they are extremely vulnerable to predators and can't outrun nor defend themselves, leading them to be a primary hunting species to small predators of the island, such as Velociraptor and Ostroraptor. So for now, until they find a herd, it looks like these two will be searching together.